Another episode of The Locker Room coming to you from All Out Bar, Queen's Park Oval, Tragreet Road, the ultimate sports bar. All right, come on down, check it out. Your boy, me, I just DJ here every Friday from 8 to 11. All right, but we ain't talking about DJing, we ain't talking about music, we talking about sports. That's what The Locker Room is all about. All right, this is the official sports talk program on Synergy TV. Real talk, real sports. And we've been looking at some of the athletes taking part in the Olympics. And the athlete up for discussion today, in this moment in time, is the bamboo tossing, pirogue pushing, javelin throwing,
Mango pelting,
boy from Toko, Keyshawn Wolcott. All right? So you want to look at Keyshawn Wolcott. He is the defending javelin champion of the world. All right? At the Olympics, the last Olympics. Took the place by storm.
Yeah, shock everybody.
Was totally unexpected. Nobody knew who Keyshawn Wolcott was. Nobody knew his name.
Yeah.
Nobody knew it had this guy from Toko that went up there to represent Trinidad and Tobago in the javelin. Nobody in Trinidad and Tobago even knew about the javelin. Some people didn't know what javelin looked like.
That's true.
Yeah.
That is true.
I remember somebody asking me, but wait, did I see man who just throw the spear? No, it's a javelin. It's a spear, partner. All right, so...
I don't know where they get the spear thing from, but, you know?
And Keyshawn Wolcott is one of the guys you're looking at for that that talk that's going around on if Trinidad and Tobago could achieve 10 gold medals by 2024.
Yeah.
I have the count at one so far. He hasn't had none. All right, having looked at Richard Thompson and Michelle Iai.
Yeah.
So let's break down Keyshawn Wolcott here and see what are the expectations heading into Rio 2016. Aaron?
All right, so honestly... my belief is that Keyshawn Wolcott would retain his gold medal at Rio 2016. While, yes, he may have had some mediocre throws, for want of a better way of saying it, back in maybe 2014 or so, where say he took the silver medal at the Commonwealth Games.
Well, that was when he was still celebrating, you know, he was still toying out.
Right, but he stepped his game up in 2015.
Yeah.
I mean, he threw a new national record of 90.16 seconds. Right. Sorry, not seconds.
Not seconds, meters. Because if he threw it in seconds,
still caught up on the track.
If he threw it in seconds, he ain't gonna win goal again, right? We wait in meters. Right,
yeah,
nice.
Still caught up on the track on the Richard Thompson thing there.
Right? If Richard Thompson run in 90 seconds, he sure
ain't winning nothing. Right?
Yeah.
But Keyshawn Wolcott, I honestly believe that he is going to retain his gold medal.
I mean,
he started throwing the javelin at 14 years, which is old compared to some of the other challengers.
All right.
Right? But at the same time, his technique, he has been able to continue improving.
Yeah.
He's been able to show that, hey, what, I'm serious about this. He's there. He's here to stay.
All right.
He has won in the Diamond League already, which is the league for the elite athletes.
That's
both
right.
track and for the field athletes.
Yeah, he put up a superb performance in the Diamond League.
He has won at the Diamond League already, so I honestly believe that he can retain his gold medal at that Olympics.
But who's the main danger that he's shot?
Who's his, sorry?
The main danger.
Who's
the person that we had to look out for? Because the reason why I ask you that, right? I don't think that the guy who was the favorite to win the javelin in the last Olympics, if somebody asks him,
he's from Norway, by the way.
But from Nicole. Norway.
Yeah.
Well, those Norwegian names, we had a seat on paper here because I can't call it off the top of my head.
I'm
to be realistic.
I'm not even going to try to pronounce that name.
But Andreas, right, we ain't even going to attempt
Andreas something.
All right, nice. Andreas something. So the reason why I asked that, right, I am sure that if they asked him that same question going into the last Olympics, well, who you think could be the only person to beat you? Keyshawn Wolcott would have been way down that list or not even on
his mind. Was not. He would not have been mentioned on the list because at 19 years, now coming off for the World Juniors, where he won the World Juniors.
Right.
But at the same time, it is his first Olympics. So they kind of maybe thought that, hey, what, Nils would take him over.
Yeah.
Nils would show him up and that he was not on that level to perform yet.
Yeah.
Right. But he shocked the world.
He showed a lot of composure.
Lot of composure. I mean, look at his celebration when they see he won the gold.
Yeah.
Right? It was so different from other athletes.
They had to pick up the coach too.
Yes,
he's a Cuban coach. Still the same coach?
Still the same coach.
Right.
But we also have to pick up his coach from his secondary school as well.
Yeah.
You know, because while his Cuban coach may have joined in and stuff, at maybe a little later time.
Yeah.
His first coach.
The early development.
Right. His first coach is responsible for that early development.
That's right.
Right. That is John Andalsio.
All right.
Right.
Well, it's actually
school coach.
And just to get it clear here, the Norwegian guy is Andreas Thorkildsen.
You trying to bite out your tongue, right?
Thorkildsen. Yeah. Andreas Thorkildsen. All
right. Right.
Funny that he has the name Thor, but he couldn't toss the javelin further than
he could
trade
that far.
All right. So I guess Thor is a punk boy.
And
all
he
right.
Was
so
he was the defending champion at the time.
He was the defending champion at the time. So Keyshawn Wolcott. As we wrap things up, gold medal.
Yeah.
Gold medal. Retains
yeah.
Gold
that
medal.
Would that would make it 9 more to go by 2024.
Okay, well, I have the count at 8, but you have it at 9.
We stick to my prediction as 9.
I still have Michelle Yeah as being the fastest woman in the world at the end of Rio 2016. But we're saying that Keyshawn Wolcott, all right? You have the support of the locker room. The locker room has given you
our endorsement.
Total support and endorsement of retaining your Olympic title at Rio 2016. So we will be watching like everybody else will, and I am pretty sure that if you do achieve that feat, it will be celebrations crazy in Trinidad and Tobago.
Another big celebration again.
Once again.
Not sure about the holiday, but it will be a big celebration again.
Well, we got a holiday for that.
Yes, we got a holiday for that.
How come I work?
We got a holiday for
I
that.
I sure I work for that holiday, boy. I'm the sourest man on the planet, boy. I must be the only man
that went
to work
for
Keyshawn Wolcott day, boy. All right. So I'll tell you what. The locker room. We got more features that we're going to be throwing at you throughout the course of the Olympics and even after the Olympics, even when the football season starts back. That's coming up very soon. The NBA is going to start back. So
yes,
this is here
we
to
even
stay.
Have the secondary schools football
the secondary
league
schools
down here
football
as well.
League. We got to feature that as well. So there's lots of sports to talk about in the locker room. So join us next time. All right? Keyshawn Wolcott, goal man.
Yeah, goal all the way.